Welcome to my basic mechanical engineering playlist. Today I am going to discuss about types of air compressor, or you can say classification of air compressors. So first of all, let's see outlines of the session. Function of air compressor. Then we will see classification of air compressor based on principle. Next, based on number of stages. Then based on pressure. And at last, based on capacity. So let's see one by one function of air compressor. An air compressor is a pneumatic device that converts power by using an electric motor, diesel or gasoline engine, etc., into potential energy stored in pressurized air, that is called as compressed air. So very simple, air compressor is a pneumatic device which converts power using an electric motor into potential energy stored in pressurized air. By one of the several methods, an air compressor forces more and more air into a storage tank to increase the pressure. So very simple, function of air compressor means converts power by using an electric motor into potential energy stored in pressurized air. Now types of air compressor. So basically air compressor are classified according to based on principle, according to based on number of stages, according to based on pressure, and according to based on capacity. Now let's start from the first one. According to based on principle, air compressors are classified as positive displacement compressor and dynamic or steady flow compressor. Once again, positive displacement compressor is further classified as reciprocating compressor and rotary compressor. Dynamic or steady flow compressor is further classified as centrifugal compressor and axial compressor. Now, according to based on number of stages, compressors are classified as single stage compressor and multi-stage compressor. According to the pressure, air compressors are classified as low compressor, medium compressor and high compressor. And at last, according to the capacity, air compressors are classified as low compressor, medium compressor and high compressor. Further, reciprocating compressors are classified as based on sides of piston, based on arrangement and based on stages. So let's see first, based on sides of piston, it is classified as single acting and double acting compressor. Based on arrangement, they are classified as inline compressor and V-shaped compressor. And according to the stages, they are classified as single stage compressor, double stage compressor and multi-stage compressor. Now once again, rotary compressors are also classified as loop compressor or root blower, then screw compressor and vane compressor. Now let's see one by one all the types of compressor briefly. So let's start from the first one. Based on principle, positive displacement compressor. Positive displacement compressor compresses the air by the displacement of a mechanical linkage. Here you can see. So the volume is reduced and pressure is increased. Now next, positive displacement is further classified as reciprocating compressor and rotary compressor. So let's see reciprocating. It works on the principle of reciprocation, which means to move piston back and forth. So very simple, piston is reciprocating inside the cylinder. That's why it is called as the reciprocating air compressor. These are capable of producing large pressure ratio with low volume flow rate. And in this figure you can see single stage reciprocating air compressor. Now next, rotary compressor. In this figure you can see rotary air compressor, that is specially screw compressor. In this figure also you can see rotary van compressor. The positive displacement of air is due to the rotating part causing compression of fluid. Here you can see they rotate at high speed, so they can handle large volume but with low pressure ratio. Example, root blower, van blower, etc. Now next, dynamic compressor. It is also known as steady flow compressor. In this figure you can see dynamic compressor. Dynamic compressors are rotary and continuous flow machines in which the rapidly rotating element accelerates the air as it passes through the element, converting the velocity head into pressure, partially in rotor and rest in diffuser. So in this figure also you can see rapidly rotating element accelerates the air as it passes through the element, converting the velocity head into pressure, partially in the rotor and rest in diffuser. So here pressure is increased due to the compromisation of velocity. Now dynamic compressors are basically two types, centrifugal compressor and axial flow compressor. So let's see the first one, centrifugal. So here you can see this is the centrifugal air compressor. A centrifugal air compressor develops pressure by accelerating air from the center of impeller due to the centrifugal force. That's why it is called as centrifugal air compressor. Then air slows down its velocity. Here you can see in a diffuser, this velocity, or you can say kinetic energy, is converted into pressure energy. Next, axial compressor. So here you can see the flow is in axial direction. That's why it is called as axial flow air compressor. Here you can see the air flows in axis of the compressor. That's why it is called as the axial flow air compressor. As the name suggests, these compressors have an axial flow. The air passes along the compressor shaft through rows of rotating and stationary blades. Here you can see rotating and these are the stationary blades. The blades convert the kinetic energy into pressure energy. Next, based on number of stages, single stage compressor. In single stage reciprocating air compressor, the entire compression is carried out in a single cylinder. Here you can see in this figure. Here also you can see the entire compression process is carried out in a single cylinder. This is a single stage air compressor. Now next one, multi-stage air compressor. Here you can see two cylinders are there. That's why it is called as multi-stage air compressor. In this figure also you can see multi-stage air compressor. In this figure you can see two-stage air compressor. Here this is the three-stage air compressor. In case of multi-stage air compressor, air is compressed in several stages in sequence. Here you can see first here it is compressed, then once again it is compressed over here. That's why it is called as the two-stage air compressor. In each stage, pressure of air is increased. In a single stage, it is very difficult to attain high pressure ratio due to the very large size of the cylinder. And so that multi-stage air compressor is preferred at that time. Now next, based on pressure limit, low pressure, medium pressure and high pressure air compressor. Low pressure air compressors, that means LPACS, which have a discharge pressure of less than 10 bar. In case of medium pressure, which have a discharge pressure of 10 bar to 70 bar. And for high pressure, which have a discharge pressure of more than 70 bar. So only you have to remember this 10 bar and 70 bar. Means if it is less than 10 bar, then it is called as low pressure. If it is more than 70 bar, then it is called as high pressure. And in between these two, that is known as medium pressure air compressor. Next, based on capacity, low capacity compressor, medium capacity compressor and high capacity compressor. Volume flow rate is less than 10 meter cube per minute. In case of medium capacity, it is 10 meter cube per minute to 300 meter cube per minute. And for high capacity, the volume flow rate is more than 300 meter cube per minute. So once again, you have to remember these two figure only, 10 and 300. In next video, we will see about the remaining types of the air compressor. So thanks my dear friends for watching this video. Press the like button to appreciate this.